Hey there, me again. Okay, so I got an email from Jason Riley, and he is asking a question about parent-teacher interviews. And it looks like they're looking to move from Zoom, which they used previously and quite successfully, I believe, to Microsoft Teams for the same thing. So what they're wanting to do is have parent-teacher meetings online, send an invite out to the parents. That invite tells them to join into a Teams meeting, and hopefully they have a similar sort of experience to what they had in Zoom. So the sorts of things that he was hoping to be able to do was get a link to the meeting. He says he can't find a meeting and doesn't want to start the meeting. Not sure what the story is there. We'll try and work it out. And he was also wanting to have the parent go in if they're joining at the wrong time, that they are put directly into a waiting room. So the teacher then can go into the waiting room and allow individual teachers in so that they don't interrupt other meetings that the parent or that the teacher is having with other parents. So let's have a look at how you do this exact same thing that you used to be able to do in Zoom, but this time with Microsoft Teams, and typically with an anonymous address. It's not somebody within our department's Teams domain. You don't have to create a team for this. It's an actual chat that you'll be creating, and those parents can join with whatever email address they have. So let's have a look at the process. I'm here in Microsoft Outlook, and what I'm going to do is create a parent-teacher event. Say it's 6 p.m. tonight, and say it's going to be a window of 2 hours that I'm going to be doing these parent-teacher sessions, and I'll have maybe 10-15 minutes with each parent, and I will allot times that I tell each parent to join the meeting, and I'll send them a link to that meeting. So I'm setting it from 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. and the title of the meeting is going to be parent. Oops, let's fix caps lock. Parent-teacher session, Mr. Hasek. So teacher's name. So that's the title of the meeting, and it's going to be a Teams meeting. So I'm going to click the little button here to say it says it's a Teams meeting, and it automatically sticks all of this stuff down the bottom here to say that it's going to be a Teams meeting. But I'm not inviting each individual parent through this invite. All I'm doing is creating an event for my personal calendar that is a block for the entire meeting time that I'm going to have with all of the parents. So what I'm going to do is where it says required who's attending, I'm going to actually put myself in here. So I'll just put myself as the required attendee, nobody else. I don't need to put any parent names in. I don't need to put any other names in the list. So that has now created my session, and I just need to hit this button that says send. And what it will do is create that session down in my calendar, which is what you can see down here. Now, the next thing I need to do is actually go back into that session by double-clicking it, and this is the link that you're going to send people to join the meeting. And you can see it's quite a long link there, but you can simply copy that to the clipboard, and you can go and create your other emails or put it into just a general message that's got the people's times on it, and this is the meeting link for my meeting for my parent-teacher session. And anybody can join at any time to that meeting within that window when I'm going to be in that meeting room. But I need to set some meeting options. I need to tell the meeting itself, the Teams meeting, how it's going to be structured. So how do you do that? Down here, you've got a little link that says Meeting Options. And because I created this meeting, it's not showing up as a link that I can just click by itself. It says down the bottom there, Control click to follow the link. So if I hold the Control key down and click on that, what it's going to do is launch a Meeting Options for this particular meeting, the parent-teacher session, Mr. Hasek, in my browser. And this is where I can set some cool little settings. Who can bypass the lobby? So what you do here is you can say only me. I'm the only person who can bypass the lobby. So if anybody gets that link to that meeting, they will show up in a waiting room and they will not be admitted to the meeting until you allow them to do so. Okay, so this option here that then says always let callers bypass the lobby, that's default to no. Announce when callers join or leave. It's a good idea for you to get a little pop-up as the teacher that says, hey, Mr. Roberts has just joined the meeting and they're sitting in the waiting room. So say yes to that one. Who can present? Really important. Say only me. We don't want people coming in and sharing their screen or doing other things. This restricts their control of the meeting and they are basically just attending your meeting. Yes, you want to allow the microphone for attendees. Yes, you want to allow the camera for attendees. You can turn these off and turn them on once they're in the meeting, allow them to do these things, but I don't think there's any need, particularly if it's a one-on-one meeting that you're having. Nobody's going to be talking over the top of other people. Allow meeting chat is up to you. That's the chat panel on the side. Do you want them to be able to maybe post a link or attach a file to share with you? There's probably very little point in them typing messages to you, but that's up to you whether you want to enable the meeting chat. I'll leave that to you to decide. Allow reactions is the little smiley, hand waving, clapping, those sorts of things that people can have. You can choose to turn those on or off. And for those people who have a steno type machine, then you can turn on cart captions. It's probably not required in most meetings. Okay, so then all you have to do is click save. And those meeting options are saved against that meeting. It says done there. Okay, the next thing that I want to do is start that meeting. So it's now 6 p.m. on Tuesday. I'm the teacher. I want to go to that meeting. Then what I'm going to do is click here to join the meeting. But obviously before this, I've sent this URL to all of the people who are going to be attending my meeting. So it's up to you to get that message out to them with just that link here, including whatever other text you want around your invitation that you're sending to each parent. But I want to start this meeting. So what I'm going to do is, because I'm going to have the camera on and the microphone on in Microsoft Teams, I will just turn this camera off for now and we'll keep going. So we're going to hold the control key down and click the link there, and that should kick off our Microsoft Teams. And where'd it go? Here it is here. So choose your video and audio options, and I'm going to just start with the microphone and the camera turned off, and I'm going to join now. I can turn the camera on if I want to, and join now. It's joining me into the meeting. Nobody else is going to be there. My microphone is muted, but I'm recording this speaking as I'm going, so don't worry about what you're seeing there. I can actually turn the microphone on in this and it shouldn't affect anything. So what we now have is a meeting where I'm the only person in the meeting. I'm waiting for my first appointment to come in. How are those first appointments going to come in? Well, let's copy this URL here, because I'm going to copy this hyperlink. I'm going to be a parent now, and I'm going to join anonymously. So I'm a parent. I don't even have an email address. I'm somebody who doesn't use computers very often, but I have got a link that was sent to me somehow, and somebody is going to want to join the meeting using that link. So let's just jump into our browser here, and I'm going to start a new in private window. So this means that I'm not signed into anything. I'm just connecting to the internet. And what I'm going to do is paste that URL in there. So it's the same as clicking a link. And it's going to say, how do you want to join the meeting? Let's just put this away. How do you want to join the meeting? And they won't see Teams come up, obviously, because they don't have Teams. And they'll click on continue on this browser. And when they do that, Teams will launch within the browser for this particular person. And the first thing it's going to do is ask them, can you tell me who you are? Now, it wants to use my microphone. I'll allow it to use my microphone. So this is, remember, I'm another person. I'm Mr. Roberts over here, and I'm wanting to join. Ignore that. And are you sure you don't want audio? Yeah, continue without audio or video. They're going to have audio and video, I assume, if they're connecting with a laptop or some other device. But in this case, because I'm the same computer using the same camera, same microphone, I'll continue without audio on video. And then it's going to ask me, okay, who are you? I am Mr. Roberts. And I can come in here and join the meeting. I'll turn those things off. Join the meeting now. What's that going to do? Let's just make this a little bit smaller. Join the meeting now. It's connecting me to the meeting. We've let people in the meeting know that you're waiting. And over here in my meeting, I'm the teacher here. I've got something that says, hey, Mr. Roberts is waiting in the lobby. We can't verify this person's identity. They've come in anonymously. They haven't come in with a Microsoft account. So you've got to trust that this is actually Mr. Roberts. But if you've got a run sheet of who all the parents are, then you can confirm that Mr. Roberts was due at 6 p.m. So Mr. Roberts is here waiting in the lobby. I clicked on view lobby on that message. I could have just admitted them straight away. But if you view the lobby, which is exactly the same as showing and hiding the participants, this button up here, you'll see that who is currently waiting in the lobby. And there could be multiple people in here because some people may have come in early. And I can, at this point, just say, okay, you're welcome to now join me in the meeting. It's going to admit this particular person. And this is where I'm going to get the echo happening. What I'll do is just turn off this microphone. Okay, so that should keep working. But here is Mr. Roberts seeing me on my meeting. I'm not seeing Mr. Roberts because he doesn't have his camera or his microphone going at the moment. But that is how you do a parent-teacher session, where you've got multiple sessions going to be happening, where you've reserved a meeting for yourself that has a two-hour block, for example, and then you're inviting different people to come in at different stages during that two-hour block, and you want them all to go into the lobby. It's not called a waiting room, it's called a lobby in Microsoft Teams. So I hope that all helps, and I will see you in the next video.